Bluey the beach. Bluey, Bingo, Mom, and Dad are off to the beach. They set up the tent, roll around in the sand, and then race to the water. Bluey and Bingo pretend the waves are trying to splash them. Here comes a big one. Mom is off for a walk along the beach. "Why do you like to walk by yourself?" asks Bluey. "I'm not sure," says Mom. "I just do." "See you soon, Little Mermaid." What a strange answer, thinks Bluey. Not long after, she finds a beautiful shell and asks to show Mom. "All right, off you go," says Dad. "For real life?" says Bluey. "All by myself?" Dad nods. "Just don't go in the water." Bingo waves her hands over Bluey's tail. Bluey laughs. "I am the mermaid who got her legs." Mom is now a tiny orange speck. Bluey frowns. "Maybe I'll just stay here with you and Dad." "But Little Mermaid, you can follow Mom's footsteps," says Bingo. "Oh yeah," Bluey grins. "Thanks." Bluey hops from one footprint to another. She runs and skips and does cartwheels in the sand until she comes across a flock of seagulls. "Can you please move?" Bluey asks politely. It's a good thing mermaids aren't scared of seagulls. Bluey laughs as she hops from one footprint to another. She runs and skips and does cartwheels in the sand until a big wave sneaks up and crashes onto the shore. It takes Mom's footsteps out to sea. "Oh, you cheeky wave," Bluey barks. "How will I find Mom now?" Just as Bluey begins to lose hope, she spots a pibby coming up for a wee-wee. A crab scuttles past. Bluey copies its funny sideways walk. "Ha ha, I'm the mermaid who got her crab legs." Bluey scampers away. She runs and runs and then skids to a stop. A jellyfish, how will I get past? She picks up a stick, pokes the blue blob. It wobbles hello. "Haha, you can't sting me, jellyfish. I am the mermaid who got her legs, but only for a day." Bluey races ahead. Looking at this amazing shell, she calls. But Mom still is too far away to hear. "Better keep going." Bluey runs and skips and does cartwheels in the sand until she comes across an old castle. Perhaps this is where all the mermaids live, she thinks, and leaves her stick as a present. Then she slowly backs away and bumps right into a pelican. Bluey begins to think she had enough of walking by herself. She looks back at Dad, but he's too tiny. He's just a tiny blue speck. If I can't go backwards and I can't go forwards, what am I gonna do? Bluey remembers the seagulls and the crabs and the jellyfish. If she got past them, maybe she can get past the pelican too. She summons every bit of courage. After all, a little mermaid has got to be brave. "I am the mermaid who got her legs, but only for a day." Then she tiptoes around the pelican. The pelican beats his great big wings and flies away. "Thank you for moving, Mr. Pelican." A familiar voice floats toward Bluey. She gasps and spins around. "Mom, Bluey!" Bluey holds the shell to Mom's ear. It has the whole beach inside it. Bluey and Mom head back together. I love walking by myself, says Bluey. Oh yeah, why is that? Asks Mom. Bluey thinks, that's a hard question. I don't know, I just do. And that's it, the end. Thank you for letting me read to you, class, and I just want to wish everybody to have a happy summer vacation, and congratulations on becoming kindergartners. Bye.